Something that's going to separate a good report from a great report is the performance. And what we're going to look at in this video is how to use the performance analyzer to assess your report's performance and identify areas for improvement. Behind the scenes, in any Power BI report, it's using DAX formulas and DAX logic to generate and display your results. And the way that we can look at this is you go to View, Performance Analyzer. That's how you get it to show up here on the side. Let's just get right into it. Let's not play around. And what we'll do is start recording. So this is something you'll do locally. Let's try to adjust a filter here. Let's say we want just Eastern Conference. Right away, we can see it picked this up. There's a DAX query. There's a visual display, other. What this is saying is here's how long the underlying query processing took. Here's how long it took to render. I've seen some examples where the query is really fast, but sometimes it takes, for whatever reason, a really long time for Power BI to render it. And I've also seen the complete opposite. Probably more common is that your query performance behind the scenes is overly complicated. It's taking forever. Once it finishes, it displays quickly, but that's a sign that, okay, something about your underlying query needs to be improved. Let's play around with this some more. Maybe we want to add these in. We're seeing change filter. What else can we do? Maybe we want to exclude this. Again, it's just offering it as a change filter. I guess I don't have too much going on this page, but that's okay. You get the point. Another thing we could do is refresh visuals. I'm going to do it again. You see the full time for that. Maybe over time it gets a little bit better, basically the same. But these are the things you can play around with. Let's say we want to add a map. And in the map, we add some more fields. We'll do city, state. Hopefully it can pick it up. I think it will. Okay, so we got a couple dots on here. And so if we refresh all visuals now, it breaks both of them down. This home city is representing that map. Now let's say you want to see those queries that it's running. As you see here, it says copy query. So let's click this. It's going to copy it to your clipboard. And I opened up a Visual Studio Code editor here, and let's drop this in here. And here we see a very well formatted, I should say, DAX query. And it shows you exactly what behind the scenes Power BI is doing to process whatever it is. In this case, it's the NBA players table. Now imagine if you had, probably more realistically, some custom things in here, or maybe you're pulling something from tabular model that behind that is running some custom DAX. This is where you can start to pick apart where things are happening, and maybe you can grab this part out and try to run this on its own and analyze it that way. I'm going to go ahead and stop this. And while it keeps it here, what you can do is actually export this log here. Let's click export. We have our reporting themes from a previous video, but we'll save this as performance.json. It's going to be this big JSON file that we can open up here. Let's open this up. And I mean, this is hard to look at. Let's see if I can at least give us something. Okay. You can see it is doing some monitoring. I'm not going to go through step by step what each of these things are. I'm sure there's a ton of documentation on this. You can see some information on the queries here, these big blocks. And in my mind, the way you would use this type of information, maybe you have some automated script that's going to pull some things out to maybe analyze performance hits or regularly check if something's hitting a threshold. Or maybe you just manually want to go through and read this. You know what you want to look for. Personally, I haven't used this output much, but I have to believe there are some uses for it once you get the hang of it, and you could do maybe some automation on it. And that is available for you there. The next thing I want to show you is this GitHub page, which is actually pretty interesting. I was able to find this. There's a GitHub page for the Power BI Performance Analyzer. So the first file we have here is the sample JSON file. And this is giving you the schema of what's going to return to you. Here's the events captured from the Performance Analyzer and all that stuff that we just looked at a minute ago. You know, all this stuff in here, name, component, start, end. Here it gives you a description of what each of these mean and how you could use it. So this next one here is actually a Power BI report that you can use to analyze. I actually didn't even realize this when I was first going through this, but this file here is something that you can take the output that we just looked at, and it's going to basically show it to you in a way that's easily readable. It's information about what's happening, maybe over time. Let's see how we can use this. Select the Performance Analyzer export file, which we just exported a second ago, by specifying the path in the M parameter. So we'll go home, edit queries, and then edit parameters. And here's transform data, edit parameters. That's not where we kept ours, but let's change this. and see if this works. Okay, apply changes. This is actually real-time testing for me. I haven't tried this myself, so I'm really interested to see how this worked. It looks like it captured it. Metadata. Okay, so visual NBA players, the map, city, all of this stuff is being captured from that JSON output and given to you. This, again, for me is very simple. You can filter it however you want. Let's see what this timeline is. I'm not quite sure what all this is, but I'm sure we could play around and learn a little bit more about this. But what this looks to be doing is taking this really long output that I mentioned that you could do something with it, and it turns out there is a solution and you can just plug and play. That's that second option here. And the last one, let's take a look, is a Word document. And if we open this up, this is going to give you an overview of the performance analyzer, how it's working, how Power BI reads it, the different components of it, so you can have a full understanding of what every layer is, how it gets to it. And like I said, this is going to take you from an average Power BI developer to an expert level. You know, if you understand how this works and can not only understand but apply these things to improve performance, you'll be highly valued on any team. Use these resources, they're there for you. I'll leave these links in the description below. I hope you found this helpful. Please leave a comment. If you have any questions, I'll do my best to answer, and I'll see you with the next video. Thanks for watching.